Looking to match Jumeleon. As Rich correctly said, Jumeleon, you know, he's very impulsive, very volatile. He'll have good days, he'll have bad days. If he's on top form today, I think M2KC is going to run away with this one. But Mara has been a legendary mage throughout the European scene for many years now. He's going to try meeting mano v mano.
I mean, just looking at these two compositions going head-to-head, it seems like Wildcard Gaming, there's a lot of opening here for M2KC. Looney on that Mistweaver Monk, he's going to be really vulnerable. Of course, Mara, without the backup of a Rogue and a Paladin of his own, it's going to be difficult, especially if Rosies and Jumeleon are just shutting him down, training him, keeping him in the kidney shot. It's really going to be up to Blizzo to disrupt some of these goes and try to keep that consistent pressure rolling onto Jumeleon.
Yeah, certainly one of the big talking points for us this year has been who have been the best mages, Europe, North America, in the world. And one of the things that you've got to say for Mara is he's been holding his own in that conversation without having a Rogue on his roster. And Rogues do make it a lot easier for the mage. Big opener here. Jumeleon already falls into the ice block. This is certainly against the expectation. Wildcard Gaming with a huge lead.
Yeah, combustion from Mara, Avatar from Blizzo, massive damage. They were able to force out that first ice block from Jumeleon. Rub Cub with the Avenging Crusader. They're looking to get aggressive, but Looney, he's just positioned in a way where it's difficult right now for Jumeleon to really get crowd control. He's looking for the Ring of Frost, but he can't find it. Great positioning from Looney. Still good consistent damage from Jumeleon from Roasty. Mara getting a little bit low, but without crowd control onto Looney, he's going to be able to easily keep Mara alive. Mara now with the Temporal Shield, he lands a full Polymorph onto Rub Cub, and now it's Jumeleon on the back foot.
Yeah, suddenly, I mean, for M2KC, they've been running at Druids, running at Paladins and Shamans, all three of those healers the entire season. Looney brings out the Monk, and he can just max range. He can avoid Rub Cub and those Hammer of Justices. He's just sitting in the back line, keeping his team stable, and because of that, so far, they've had the better of all offense. You can see Rub Cub has used a lot of his healing modifiers. He's not got his Avenging Crusader for quite a while here, meaning that the next Polymorph, he's not going to be able to recover from it too easily. If they can land that, if Mara can push in, get that Polymorph, Jumeleon could be in a lot of trouble. He's playing fire. He has no ice blocks, man.
Ooh, nice double Dragon's Breath, Ring of Frost. Nicely done, but Rub Cub gets the ultimate sacrifice, denying that crowd control. Nicely done by Rub Cub, and now it's Looney in a Polymorph. Marl's going to have to play defensive in this situation. Temporal Shield rolling. Looney with no life cocoon doesn't really have too many catch-up mechanics. Now into a Hammer of Justice. Still, Blizzo keeping up the damage consistently on to Mara in this game. And for Wildcard Gaming, this game is looking pretty good. Mara, he still has his ice block. The pressure seems in favor. The one thing I'm noticing M2KC has on their side is the fact that Rub Cub's mana is doing a little bit better. And I feel like that trend will continue as the game goes on.
Yeah, it's certainly true. Rub Cub on the Paladin does such a great job. You know, he plays for that late game as well. Well, as all the aggression that this team brings. So it really has been a good balance for M2KC, one of the many reasons that they are the number one seed here, representing North America at the summer finals. Full Fear now, Blizzo looking for the kill, forces the Divine Shield up, Blessing Protection.
Whoa!
And they get the kill nonetheless. M2KC dropped out in game one.
For the Mimu Kitty Cats, it should be their tournament to throw. Are they just going to get knocked down in the first round, Wildcard Game, and trying to get themselves on match point?
Yeah, and speaking with Mara, I mean, we saw him play a lot of Frost Mage in the AWC, but playing Fire Mage is something he does a lot on ladder, and he said this composition M2KC is running, the Fire Mage Assassination Rogue Holy Paladin, is something he sort of specializes in and plays a lot. So if any player could sort of come up with an answer, I feel like Mara is definitely in a good position to do so. We'll have to see what Wildcard Gaming can get done in game number two. The effective crowd control on Rub Cub last game was really crucial for their team to actually have so much pressure. Right now, you can see M2KC, they're going to be striking first. Hammer of Justice on Looney, but unfortunately, Jumeleon not able to find the Polymorph or preemptive Life Cocoon on that first kidney shot, and Mara's going to be completely fine.
Yeah, Looney just had stellar positioning once again. He was over by the side pillar. Meanwhile, Jumeleon was on the central tomb, so even if he double blinked there, probably wouldn't have actually got the distance in time to actually connect to Looney, and even if he had, Blizzo would have been all over him. So once again, Wildcard Gaming, Looney in particular, with fantastic positioning in the early stages of this one. Now Full Fear, Blessing Protection comes in. Can they land the Polymorph? No. Good Shadow Step, Kidney Shot. Now Roasty's looking to reverse with the Vendetta.
Yeah, big damage on Mara. Rub Cub getting aggressive too with the Avenging Crusader. Mara dipping low. Looney, though, with the Thunder Focus T, massive heals, incoming War Banner also dropped down there by Blizzo to deny any crowd control. Marl's kind of struggling right now to get the Polymorphs we saw in game number one. Rub Cub's had good position. This pillar, this tomb in the center, is really effective for Repka, but a Dragon's Breath comes in. Unfortunately, Maro not able to find the Polymorph. Blizzo still all over Jamili, causing massive consistent pressure. Now Roasty's reconnecting to his target. M2KZ, both mages really in this game are getting shut down quite a bit. We really haven't seen too many Polymorphs.
Yeah, certainly haven't. I mean, I think both teams have kind of taken it a little bit slower here. Rubcub in particular, he's not really playing too aggressively. He's just line of sighting Maro, as you say, allowing Roasties to kind of stay all over him, deny Polymorphs. And I actually think that plays into M2KC's hands. They do have the mana lead right now. They seem to have the pressure lead as well, looking potentially to force the ice block. Instead, Rallying Cry from Blizzo enables the Life Cocoon to come out before the cauterize. Very nicely done. Good defensive play. Now full counter spell over on Rubcub. They're trying to get damage on Jamili, but once again, fantastic positioning all over the tomb. Rubcup denying any polymorphs to follow that one up, and M2KC will survive.
Yeah, this is normally not how we see M2KC really play. They're playing very defensive right now. Jamili realized he kind of got baited in the last game, so instead of that, he's just going to allow Roasties to do as much work as possible. Now pushing in, potentially looking for the crowd control. There it is, Hammer of Justice. Unfortunately, gets polymorphed. Nicely done there by Maro. It actually might have been Blizzard with a Spell Reflect, but ultimately Jamili not able to find the crowd control. Double Dragon's Breath comes in. Is he going to get the Ring of Frost? Maro could be in some trouble, but he gets denied. The interrupts from Maro and Blizzard have been on point. They are just shutting down Jamili every step of the way. Ultimate Sacrifice rolls in from Rubcub. Jamili will survive, but decent pressure here for M2KC on Maro.
I really like that Ultimate Sacrifice from Rubcub. It's a 2-minute cooldown as opposed to Ice Block, which is 4 or 5 minutes, so it's much more efficient of a trade. Now, if they do, you know, get another big crowd control chain with the next Combustion, Jamili could Ice Block it, and then Ultimate Sacrifice will rotate back up. So that's what we're looking at. Full Polymorph onto Rubcub. Big pressure on Jamili. He's kiting away, though. He's been holding on to those Shimmers. Still forced into the Ice Block, though. Massive damage from Wildcard Gaming. And I mean, Wildcard Gaming, we talked to Method Black. Three of the members on that team were saying that these guys were not even competition for this one. They were super demoralized, but Swapsy was one who's like, you know what? The raw talent on this roster, you can never quite count them out. And I mean, in this one, they've just been crushing Jamili so much offense. It's so scary. I mean, Rubcub, he's even signed full behind on mana now as well.
I think counting out Wildcard Gaming in any tournament is just completely foolish with how, you know, like you said, raw talented these players really are. Maro, Blizzo, Looney, as well as Zipai on the bench right now. These guys are phenomenal roster. M2KC, they're struggling. They're behind in this match, but there's still hope. Looney's mana isn't doing great. Full Hammer of Justice lands. Jamili looking for a Polymorph. Can he find the Ring of Frost? Unfortunately denied, and you could tell Wildcard Gaming, they had a game plan. They're playing very well defensively, offensively as well, and M2KC, they just haven't found the opening we normally see from this team. Finally, a full Polymorph lands. Looney, though, I think he actually got the preemptive life cocoon. No, he didn't, but there's just not that much damage. Maro's going to be fine. He pops his temporal shield. That should top him off. And right now, Wildcard Gaming, they're just in the driver's seat.
Yeah, I mean, Rich kind of alluded to it. There's Warriors and then there's Blizzo, and Jamili was the one. He basically said he feared Blizzo above anyone else, and Blizzo's just been all over him. He hasn't been able to get aggressive. They just forced the Divine Shield out. There are very little defensive cooldowns left for M2KC. We're approaching Dampening, but Jamili might not make it. The Ultimate Sacrifice comes out in the nick of time. It was so close to being 2-0 in favor of Wildcard Gaming, but now they truly have nothing left. Morrowstar.
This is
ice
nice.
Block. They are going to force out that ice block. It's going to come down to a cutthroat finish.
Yeah, really nicely done by M2KC. Jamili surviving on 5% health. I still think he has his cauterize available, so that cheat death effect for Jamili is still going to be active. But Rubcup with no cooldowns, he's really going to struggle. Polymorph lands on Looney. Maro gets interrupted. Roasty all over him. This is danger time for both these teams. Full kidney shot lands on Maro. Jamili's still getting low. Blizzo chopping him up. He's caught into a leg sweep, and the cauterize is going to do nothing. Play a passive game. I just feel like the consistent damage Blizzo is able to put out is just really overwhelming Rubcub.
Yeah, I mean, I think the curveball is a perfect way of describing it. Basically, they've thrown the kitty cat to curveball, and Jamili's still in the corner playing with that ball. He needs to get his head in the game here for game three as we go up against Wildcard Gaming. I really think the thing is offense. Like, last game, we saw them play a very defensive game, and it didn't seem to work out. In fact, for me, it was slightly worse than game one. So I think if they go in, get very, very aggressive here, get the crowd control early on to Looney, potentially even attacking Blizzo could be an option. Attacking Looney, they could swap it up a lot here in this one. Blizzo, we've talked about it in the backstage. Arms Warrior is definitely a little bit scary, and Rubcup recognizes that. He's playing very aggressively with his cooldowns, already using out the Divine Shield, the Ultimate Sacrifice. He wants to enable Jamili to get aggressive, get those crowd controls over onto Looney, because they have Force 2 Trinkets, they have the Vendetta available. I think they're going to go for a swap either onto Blizzard or Looney.
Yeah, but RubCub, he's already burned through so much. He does have his Avenging Crusader. That is a last sort of lifeline for M2KC. Jamili, of course, with that Ice Block, but just pressure in favor of Wildcard Gaming once again. Marl Trinkets out of the Kidney Shot. Full Hammer of Justice on Looney. M2KC, can they get the crowd control that they need? Smoke Bomb drops out to protect Jamili from Marl's damage. That is enough to keep him alive right now. Mana still in favor of Looney and Wildcard Gaming. Finally, some decent control coming in, but for M2KC, we really want to see them get the crowd control on Looney. Start getting those consistent setups. Right now, no one on Wildcard Gaming has a Trinket, and this is the moment where they need to strike with a full Kidney Shot on Marl, full Polymorph on Looney. If they can get that done, they can get the Ice Block from Marl.
Yeah, there was actually a bit of a miscommunication on M2KC there, and you can see it because we have this new UI element in the center. You can follow the target, see their buffs, debuffs. Marl was actually able to dispel RubCub's Blessing of Protection and remove the Vendetta from Roasties almost immediately, completely shutting down one of their biggest offensive cooldowns, quite honestly. M2KC all over the place in this game. RubCub now caught up in crowd control. No breakers available. Full Stormbolt. Jamili, are you going to have to use the Ice Block? It looks likely. There it is. The massive defensive cooldown. Offensives downs. Defensives down. M2KC struggling here in game three.
This is match point. Wildcard Gaming 2-0 up in this series. They win this game, and it's looking like they might. I mean, right now, Maro, he's got the Combustion rolling back up. Blizzo has a lot of damage available with that Avatar as well. Jamili, no lifelines. RubCub, no defensive cooldowns. 13 seconds left on the ultimate sacrifice. They have to hold on. Interrupt on Marl. Jamili trying to get control of the game right now. Spamming out some Polymorphs on Blizzo, but Blizzo rolls in. Massive damage incoming. Dragon's Breath denies it a little bit, but Jamili just holding on by a thread. He's got the Cauterize. Is it going to be able to keep him alive? He's running. He's trying to hide, but the Stormbolt on RubCub denies any heals. Wildcard Gaming complete.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.